Hey loves, Chantera Kaba here. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, welcome. I'm so excited to have you. In today's video, I will be jumpstarting my new How to Start a YouTube series. So you guys, please stay tuned for this entire series. All the videos in this series will be inside a playlist, but specifically in today's video, I'll be dropping all the gems on affordable YouTube equipment such as cameras, tripods, and lighting. Now I understand what may be affordable to some people may not be affordable to everyone, but in this video I will be personally sharing two camera options that I can personally vouch for. Now one I'm pretty sure everyone has access to, and that is an iPhone. So the iPhone I have is my iPhone 8 Plus. I'll be showing two clips on footage from my iPhone. The first clip I believe I recorded at 1080p at 60 frames per second, and then the second clip I recorded at 4K at 60 frames per second as well. Now the reason I chose those frames per second is because they shoot the fastest. Now if you shoot anything lower than 60 frames per second, then like your words tend not to match up with your, your voice tends not to match up with your words and stuff like that. So it does move slow. So I recommend 60 frames per second. But yeah, so let me show you guys that footage here. Hey love, so this first clip is shooting in 4K at 60 frames per second. Hey love, so this shot is shooting in 1080p at 60 frames per second. And this is also a huge tip. If when you're recording from your iPhone, make sure you are using your back camera, because your back camera is always better than your front camera. If you want to do a test run by just like filming like some food or something like that, try to do it on your front camera and then try to do it on your back camera. I promise you guys will notice a difference, and you do not even have to do food. You can just do it on yourself, but you guys will notice a difference. And also, when you're using your back camera, of course, it is going to be kind of hard to see what you're doing. So I recommend doing a test run just to make sure you are in frame. And I also recommend, if you can, like taping a mirror behind your phone, like just to see and just to always make sure that you're in focus and you're in frame. Now, the second camera that I can vouch for is, of course, the camera that I am currently recording on. This is my go-to camera. I use this camera for everything, for pictures, for video, all of that. And that is mainly because I did a lot of research when I was thinking about starting my YouTube channel on what kind of camera I needed. So I wanted a camera that took great photos, but I did not want it to lag in video quality. So what I did was I looked at some of my favorite YouTubers, and I went like to their description box, and they had like their cameras and what they were using, what settings and all of that. So that is exactly what I did. I researched some videos here on YouTube of people who had the same cameras as them. And, you know, they did like little test shots and stuff like that. So that is how I found my camera. But there's also a little backstory. So when I was going to my favorite YouTuber channels, their cameras were kind of expensive. So I would look them up. I look up the quality. But after I looked up the quality, then I looked at how much they cost. I'm like, okay, that's not my budget. My budget was around $400 for the camera and the body lens. And by this time, it was tax season. So yeah, $400 was my budget. I was not trying to go over there for the lens, the camera, the charger, all of it. So let me show y'all how God works. So as I mentioned, I looked at them, the cameras my favorite YouTubers were using, and they were very expensive. So, or if they were in my price range, they didn't come with the lens. A lot of people, and I purchased my camera off eBay, a lot of people on eBay only sell the camera body. It doesn't come with the lens. So I kid you not, I did this research for about a week or two. I even asked my family member, that's all I'm gonna say, asked the family member if they knew where I could get a camera from, and long story short, they didn't know. So I searched on eBay, and let me tell you guys how much I paid for this camera. It came with a lens, it came with the HDMI cord, came with a battery, it came with a charger, came with all of it. I purchased my camera from eBay on March 1st, 2019. I paid $364.99. This was a very affordable price for a DSLR with the lens and a flip screen. So that was one of the qualities that I was searching for when I was looking at cameras. I wanted something that had a flip screen, because when I did like search for cameras in my budget, I did see a lot of cameras that were in my price range, but they did not have a flip screen. Now, what I just told you guys, if you use your iPhone, then you can like tape a mirror behind it or make sure there's a mirror behind it so you guys can see what's going on. But I didn't want to do all that. I wanted a flip screen. Now, there was also something else I wanted. I wanted to be able to edit or like have my photos from my camera go directly to my phone. So there was a sacrifice I had to make. But let me just tell you guys, the upgraded model of my camera is a T7i, I believe, and that's the one I wanted. Now, I couldn't find that one at, you know, a good price. So then I began to and I found the T6i, which is the, it didn't have a flip screen. So it was not the T6i, it was a Canon T6. This one is at an affordable price. I will try to link that down below, but it's at a very affordable price. But I do want to encourage you guys to, you know, be mindful if you purchase that camera, because one thing that was a little iffy about me is that if I got on eBay and I seen a lot of sellers, like if I seen one seller that sold like 30 of the same item, that kind of raises eyebrows for me, and I'm like, no, that kind of, if you're not a like direct retailer, like if you're not working for Canon, that I don't see why you have 30 of the same thing. Like, are you getting it manufactured from China or something like that? So I will kind of be mindful. But there is one of my favorite YouTubers. She's actually a local YouTuber from where I'm from, and she uses a Canon T6. So that is actually where I got the idea from. She had it in her bio, not bio, her description box, and that is actually where I found it. So if she does still have the link, which I'm pretty sure she does, because mind you, I started my channel in 2019, but she still has the link. I'll link it down below and you guys can go check it out. So overall, Canons usually range from about $450 to $1,000. So I was very fortunate to find my camera at that price. So those of you who are just beginning your search, I will recommend, just like I said, I went to some of my favorite YouTubers and I went to their description box and they had what kind of camera they use. So you guys, please look into that. But some more cameras that I found to be like very good in quality, the Canon T5i, which is, well, actually, like I told y'all, I wanted the Canon T7i because it had the option to where I can get the pictures directly from my camera to my phone. But what actually encouraged me to look at the T5i is because, for one, the Canon T7i was very expensive. So I'm like, okay, if I just get a camera in the same family, like, how would that work? So I looked at the T6i as well, and that was kind of out of my price range too, but I would have gotten it if I did not find this one. Now, when I found this one, I was like, yes, I am getting it. I did not care, because this was a very great deal for everything that was included. But you guys, I know there are still some deals out there, so for you guys who are just getting started, make sure you do your research, but take your time as well before purchasing it, because like I said, it did take me about 2 weeks. But when I seen this, after doing all of my research, I knew that this was a great deal. And of course, I prayed over it before it made it to my house, that nothing messed up. And this camera, I've had my YouTube channel since 2019. It is now 2021, so we're good. Also, I want to tell you guys that when you purchase your camera, you do not have to go crazy and get all the camera lenses. You do not have to go crazy and get new batteries, get new SD cards and all that. Because let me tell y'all, when I started my YouTube channel, and this was before I did not upgrade all these things until after I hit 1,000 subscribers. When I first started my YouTube channel, so for about 1 to 2 years, even though I took a break because I went to school and all of that, for about 1 to 2 years, I had one camera battery. And quick story on that, I did go out and purchase another camera battery, but y'all, like I was saying before, I purchased it from eBay. It was a person selling about 100 batteries of the same kind. They were not a Canon retailer. Long story short, it was a fake battery. They deleted their eBay account and all that, and eBay gave me a refund. But when I started out, one camera battery. Yes, I had to recharge my battery and all that. So when you hear YouTubers say, oh, my camera battery died, they're most likely telling the truth. So now I currently have 3 camera batteries, but that is because I got a deal on Amazon. But you guys, like I said, do not rush to go out and get camera batteries. What else? You don't have to rush and go get extra SD cards. These will be investments further down the line, but if you do not have a YouTube channel already, just start. That's the first thing you want to do, is just start with whatever you have. Just start. Now, of course, you can't invest in a camera like I did, but like I'm saying, you do not have to go out and invest in all these camera lenses and all of that. Now, I did eventually, when I got some more money, invested in another lens. So currently I have 2 camera lenses, I have 3 batteries, and I think that's all. Oh, I bought a camera bag. You can't invest in a camera bag. This camera bag wasn't much at all. But I bought a camera bag, that lens. Oh, and I bought me a tripod, but we'll be getting into tripods now. This is the first tripod I started with when I made my YouTube channel. And this tripod is currently priced at $18.87 on Walmart's website. So if you want to check it out, I'll leave it down below. Now, the second one I will not be able to show you guys on camera because, of course, I'm using it right now. And it would be a lot for me to take this camera off, put it on this one, then put it back on that one. So I'm not going to do all that. But I'll show you guys right here. This is my current tripod. And the main difference that I noticed between the two is that this one is less sturdy than the one I'm using right now, or the one you just seen. This one is less sturdy. And it's very lightweight compared to the other one, but the other one is still not heavy, but it's much durable. This one goes up to 50 inches and the one I'm currently using goes up to 66 inches. So that is one of the main reasons why I did want to upgrade it, because I did want a taller tripod for when I go outside and take my pictures. You know, I'm like 5'5", so I did want something a little bit taller to take my pictures. With this one, I had to do certain angles and all that, but I made it work. So once again, I say start with what you can. You do not have to invest thousands of dollars like some YouTubers or may have you led. You may think that you need to invest all this money to start a YouTube channel, but I promise you, you do not. And once I get into this lighting, you guys, it's a game changer for real. Because when I first started my YouTube channel, I thought I was going to have to pay like $75 to $100 to $150 for lighting. And let me just tell you guys, the lighting that I currently use, and it is great lighting. This lighting is $37.99. Let me make sure I got that price right for y'all. $37.99. And I'm going to put this right here on the screen. These are my old faithful umbrella lights. And let me just tell y'all, I brag on these lights. I tell everybody about these lights. These are my freaking lights. Let me just show y'all one. And most of the time I do use one, but lately I've been using 2 and I do notice a difference with 2. So this is with 2. Let me show you guys with 1. This is with 1 light, and of course, let me try to put it in the middle so you guys can see. Alright, so this is with 1 light, and of course I can adjust my camera settings to make it a little bit brighter. But as you see, it did look better with 2 lights. So let me just show y'all. I believe this is what my settings were. Okay, so this is 1 light. The lighting is still kind of okay, but like I said, I can adjust my camera settings. Now, let me show you guys with no lights, with just my regular light bulb. This is now with no lights, and of course, I can still adjust my camera settings, but yeah. These umbrella lights, they do wonders. Whew, now we're a little bit too bright. Let me show y'all some melanin. Okay, there we go. Now, my lighting is kind of out of place, because I did just rearrange them, but you guys get the drift. So this lighting is $37.99, less than $50, less than $40. So you guys, please purchase this lighting if you're just on your YouTube channel. No, you do not have to spend $100 on a ring light. No, you do not have to buy multiple umbrella lights. This, the link I showed you up here, and will also be down in the description box. It comes with 2 umbrella lights. It comes with 2 light bulbs. As I told y'all, I started my channel in 2019. These light bulbs are still going strong with me, so I did not have to replace them, and I don't mind replacing and reinvesting back into the company that I purchased them from, because these are amazing lights and I recommend them to everyone, including you guys. So if you guys are just starting your channel out, please purchase these lights. So just as a recap, I showed you guys 2 camera options. The first one is the camera that I'm currently recording on, the Canon T5i. All details will be down below in the description, and I may not have a link directly to this camera because, like I said, I purchased mine off eBay. So of course the seller I purchased from only had one listing, and this was about 2 years ago, so it's gone. But you guys can definitely look it up and do your own research, and you may want different qualities in a camera. Like I said, I wanted my camera to take great photos and not suck in video quality. So please do your research. There are a lot of videos of people doing like reviews on different cameras here on YouTube, and that is how I found my camera. And the second option was my lovely iPhone 8 Plus. No, I do not care for upgrading to an iPhone 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, because they're all the same phone if you ask me. Now the camera quality may get a little better, but I mean, to each his own. Now the second thing I showed you guys were tripods. So the one I'm currently using, of course I didn't show you guys that one physically, but I did show you virtually right here, and you can purchase it off Amazon if you want to, and if you have enough money or a little extra money in your budget. This one was $39.99, I believe, and then this one right here is $18.87. this one is my starter tripod, and I recommend you guys start with this one first, just until you like get your content up and start being consistent on YouTube. This one was $18.87, and this is a great starter tripod. And also with this tripod, you can it comes with this, so you're able to put this on top of there to use your phone, and then right here you can put your camera on it. So it's very versatile, and the one I have that came from Amazon, it comes with it as well. And then lastly, what I showed you guys in today's video of affordable YouTube equipment was my lighting. And I also forgot to mention you guys one other lighting option that is absolutely free, and you guys please guess what this lighting is. Daylight. Now I know a lot of you may not have a certain time, or you may not have a flexible schedule that will allow you to record videos when it is daylight outside. Like right now it is currently 7:35 where I'm recording, because I do work during the day, so I have to record at night. So these umbrella lights are a great option. But if you have the option, and I know a lot of us don't have these fancy lofts like these YouTubers, I wanted to say hotels at first, but I know we don't all have these fancy lofts like most of these big and famous YouTubers, where they have like the big windows and stuff that brings in so much light. And if you live in an apartment like me, then it may be hard to get the best lighting. But I promise you, if you have like some type of window that does get access to a lot of sunlight, then please sit by that window and use that natural light that God gave us. It is 100% free, and it is the best lighting. They even taught me that in cosmetology school, it's the best lighting. So that pretty much wraps up this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys learned something from this video. I hope you will take something from this video. If it's anything, if it's these fancy umbrella lights, anything from this video, I hope you take something from it. And please make your dreams happen. Start this YouTube channel today. As always, don't forget to educate, encourage, and empower by sharing this video. Also, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you all in my next video. Bye.